Good morning. Welcome to our service for Ramona Hurtado. We're going to open up in a word of prayer, and then we're going to have some time of worship. I know that Ramona, she loved to worship the Lord. You know, and just remembering her at Calvary Chapel South Bay, all those years, she would come and just go to the right of the building there and just sit down, just ready to get her worship on. And so we're here today to celebrate her life. You know, celebrate the beautiful life that she lived and how she loved God and how she loved to worship the Lord. With that, let's open up in a word of prayer. Father, we thank you. As we gather as a family, we can look at this day as a sad day, or we can look at it as a beautiful day of celebration, to know that Ramona is in your presence today, rejoicing with her maker, leaping for joy, where there's no more sickness, there's no more crying, no more tears, but there is rejoicing in the presence of God. And Father, we ask that your blessings will be upon this service. Lord, that you will meet us here. And God, that you'll give us the strength and the ability to continue on with our lives. Lord, that we look to you, the author and the finisher of our faith, in Jesus' name. And all God's people say, amen. On behalf of Eleanor and the family, we'd like to welcome you all here this morning as we gather to say our see you later. This is not really a goodbye or a time of us to tear up, but a time for us to rejoice and to say see you later to a beautiful woman, a woman that loved God, a woman that has so much joy in her heart, you know, to reach out to others. And that's why we're all here this morning. So we like to welcome you, and we like to say, you know, thank you for joining us this morning as we celebrate the going home of Ramona Hurtado. At this time, we're going to have Pastor Kevin lead us in a time of worship.
Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord our God. You reign forever. Our hope, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God. Oh, the everlasting God. Yeah, you do not faint, you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. And you lift us up on wings like eagles. And strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We wait upon the Lord. I've got it. You reign forever. Lord, you're our hope. Yes, you are our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God. You do not faint, you won't grow weary. Yeah. You're the defender of the weak. and you comfort those in need, and you lift us up on wings like my Savior God to thee. And how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. Yeah. How great thou art, and how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation and take me home. Oh, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. This sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. Yeah, yeah. How great thou art, and how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art. What it'll be like when I'm walking by your side, Lord. I can only imagine, oh, what my eyes will see when your face is before me. It's surrounded by your glory. What will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? To my knees and will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. And surrounded by your glory. What will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees and will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Oh, Lord, thank you today that it's not just wishful thinking that heaven is real, Lord. We're not just hoping today that maybe somehow we just might be able to gain favor with this God who just might like us, Lord. You say that you love your people with an everlasting love, Lord. And so what a privilege it is to be able to even be here today to sing these songs for my sister who'd sit in the third or fourth row and just lift her hands and heart to God every week after week. Lord, now she is in your presence, doing that in front of the God whom she had never seen before. And here she is today, Lord. So we love you today, and we just pray that you just reveal your love and truth to us, Lord. These have been tough times, and this has been a tough year, and so we're praying just for your peace to rest on us now. Bless Pastor Tuvai and the family as they share, in Jesus' name.
This time is our scripture reading. It'll be read by Ramona's, this would be Ramona's favorite passage of scripture as she lived her life just trusting.
About dancing, she loved to dance. So I picture her up there dancing around. But Psalms 121, she loved, and it says, I lift my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life, and the Lord will watch over you coming and going, both now and forevermore. So I know he's with my grandma, and he's watching over all of us too. And she's just waiting for us to get there to join her. Thank you.
You know, in times of funerals, times of memorials, is a time to remember a life. And also it's a time for us to look to the Lord in our difficult times. At this time, it's time for the eulogy, and Eleanor asked if I could just read the eulogy. That will be the obituary of Ramona Hurtado. And it says, Ramona went to meet our Lord on March 28th. She passed peacefully at the age of 86. Born on January 15, 1935 in Chicago, Illinois, and lived the last 76 of her years of her life here in California. She married the love of her life in 1951. Together they had almost 50 years, wonderful years of marriage until Victor's passing in February of 2001. Together she and Victor were blessed with 6 children. In later years, their blessings continue with the spouses our Lord had chosen for their children. In addition, Ramona and Victor became loving grandparents, great-grandparents, and most recently, great-great-grandparents. Ramona was referred to as a GMO by families and many friends, or Kiko was another loving name she was entitled to, as this is a Spanish slang meaning kiss. She loved wearing her red lipstick and would never leave home without it. If you were lucky enough to be her child or grandchild, then you would experience her bright red lipsticks upon prints on your face. Ramona leaves this legacy with a daughter and many of her granddaughters who also continue to the red lipstick tradition. Ramona loved her job working for the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department and made lifelong friendship with close circles of coworkers. She retired in 1993, which allowed her and Victor to start a life of traveling, road trips, going on cruises, all of that which they both love. In their early years, they loved their annual family vacation of camping and experiencing all of what nature has to offer in some of California's most beautiful forests. After Victor's passing, Ramona attended a wonderful bereavement group, which gave her the understanding of how to handle her grief, sadness, loneliness, and the feeling of being lost. There in her grief, she met a close-knit group of wonderful people who were all going through the same emotional roller coaster. Here she developed another circle of some very long, lifelong friendship. Together, they got involved in enjoying various activities such as crafts, crochet, playing the ukulele, visiting each other's houses, shopping, going out to lunch together, took field trips, and most of all, discovered line dancing. Yes, she is dancing up in heaven, amen. Ramona has such a love for line dancing that she joined the talented Carson Senior Line Dancers. Together, they will perform at various parties, park recreation events, convalescent homes, and holiday shows. She kept physically active between the performing dates, attending line dancing classes 5 days a week, and learning a new choreographic dance steps. Ramona lives on in our hearts and leaves a life of precious memory to her family and friends. She cherishes her family of many sisters, brothers, nieces, nephews, and cousins. But most important, she loved her Jesus, believed in him, spoke daily of him, had lots of faith in him, and gave her life to him. She read her daily devotion and read of him through the Bible. She had many favorite Bible scripture, but particularly loved Psalm 121 that was read today, which begins, "As I lift my eyes to the mountain, where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth." Much like her husband, Victor, Ramona had a fondness for hummingbirds. They often fly around her home, and Ramona had one particular hummingbird she named Stinker. Since he does not like to share his nectar and will protect it from other hummingbirds before leaving this earth, Ramona told her daughter to keep watch for three visiting hummingbirds. In spirit, these hummingbirds will be mom, dad, and loved ones. It's a reminder of a quote often said, "Those we love don't go away. They fly beside us every single day." So spread your beautiful wings, Ramona, and let your spirit soar straight up to heaven. And that's where she's at today, in the presence of our Lord, rejoicing with her maker today. What a great reminder to us of a life that love God and love life to the fullest. Amen. At this time, we have a poem that will be read by one of Ramona's great granddaughter, Scarlett Orte.
If flowers grow in heaven, Lord, please pick a bundle for me. Place them in my Jima's arms and tell her they're from me. Tell her I love her and miss her, and when she turns to smile, place a kiss upon her cheek and hold her for a while.
Like I mentioned before, it's time for us to reflect upon the memories or some things that maybe spoke out to us in the life of Ramona. And so this time, we're going to open up to anyone in attendance who would like to come up and share their fond memories of Ramona.
Hello, everyone. For those that don't know me, I am one of Ramona's sons. My name is Victor. It still hasn't hit me yet with seeing all these beautiful flowers, but I know it will at some time. But, you know, growing up as a child, you didn't really know how well you had it with a great mom. And to improve on that, my dad was, they were both from the same type of personality. They were, they helped us as kids all the time, even as adults. They would offer help, ask if everything was okay, if we needed anything. But she may be gone, but she will still be in my heart. And I have 65 years of memories in this head of mine. So it was a good life. Thank you.
My name's Nick Ortega. I worked with Ramona at Carson Station. There's a few other of us here. She was our detective secretary, and I'll tell you a few stories from her. You know, she had family, grandchildren, and everything, but she had all this little dicks out there, which she took care of. She was so amazing. When you have someone that's arrested, they have what they call an in custody package. And it tells you some of their background and so on and so forth. She went so far and would dig, and she could tell you how much that person weighed when they were bare or born. And it was very, very helpful, because when you're questioning these people, we used to do all the interviewing in those days. Things have changed a lot now, so but we used to do it on our desk. Now, Ramona's desk was in the detective bureau, not in the other big area where all the other secretaries were, like Demi and Susanna, and they were all good. But like I said, she took care of us. Her desk used to be in the corner right outside the lieutenant's office, and it faced right across from me, probably from me to that first chair there. And she used to hear my interviews. I don't speak Spanish, so she did a lot of interpreting for me. But this is before cell phones and texting and all that other stuff. She would hear me interviewing and stuff like that. And she would get on her little computer, which she was magic with, where she could, like I said, she could bring out information on anybody from the time they were born. And she'd call me on the phone and say, hey, that son of a bitch is lying. I'm sorry. You know, and you know, ask him this, you know, blah, 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 you know. And a lot of times with those packages don't show the times you were arrested and not convicted. So she would give me all that little info, which I could, you know, squeeze the person and, you know, make a liar out of them. And I mean, she would have it, but that phone kept ringing. I go, God, Ramon, let me do my job. You know, I'm not that dumb. I could do a little bit. One time I had a parolee just out of this state prison. I'll try to keep it clean, but anyway. I mean, he was all buffed out and everything, and I knew there was going to be a problem with this guy. And I had his parole officer, made it all nice and dandy where we're going to interview him. Told my fellow detectives, you know, it's going to be a time we're going to have to be out there. We're going to do battle with this guy. Ramona saw it because she didn't like people yelling at me. She'd probably make me get a haircut right now. But anyway, there was a table a little bigger than this between her desk and my desk, and we call it the in custody table. They had all the books for everybody that's arrested and which detective was assigned those cases. So Ramona saw that this interview wasn't going good. So she got up with her little, moved the table to give us some wrestling room, because she knew the fight was going to be on. And sure enough, it was on. And she had to go back and tell the girls, all the secretaries wanted to run through the little opening to watch. She had them all back, you know. And then after we picked this guy up and, you know, took him in and everything, then she came with my little booking package, and here it is. She had it all ready, and she got a statement from the parole officer, the whole works, man. She was awesome. She was dynamic. You guys had a little nickname from her, and we had one for her, and I'm going to have to ask Demi or Susanna, because I don't remember it, but we used to call her Cleo. Now, I don't know if she was doing some play or whatever. She's supposed to be Cleopatra. I can't remember. You know, it's old, you know. But I have to find out what that was all about. She was so respected, not only from her fellow workers and us little dicks, but we gave her a retirement party. And I've been involved in a lot of them. We had people, she could have ran for sheriff and been elected. That's how many people were calling and wanted to go to that party. I mean, that Carson Community Center was packed. I mean, we got her a room in the hotel. And all your little grandchildren are all running around in your pajamas in the room after the party was over. But it was so amazing. All the people, way back, coming back and wanting, save me a seat. How can I get in? You know, that's how much respect she had. Last time I talked to her, this is before cell phones and texting and all that other stuff, and this is the only time she ever put me off. She says, Nick, I don't have the time. I have a performance at the Carson Community Center. And it was her dancing. But anyway, family, thank you for sharing your mother.
My name is Farrah Clark, and I miss Grandma Mona very much, and I know you do too, and I have a bunch of memories from when Grandma Mona was here, and one memory, I was at Grandma Mona's house. I gave Grandma Mona a hug, and that's all I wanted to say.
Susanna asked me to speak last night, and I says, I'm not ready for this, but I did work with Ramona 45 years ago. Right after I graduated from high school, I got my first job for the County of LA. And I had the best team of people. It was actually the best job in my life. I was too young to appreciate, but through the years, I've been single mom, taking care of my mom, working 2-3 jobs in ophthalmology. I kept in touch with a beautiful team of people. Ramona has been my angel, going through trials of life. She lifts my spirit. I loved Ramona. And I tell everybody how God showed me all the different jobs in UCLA, police department, and Sheriff's Department was the best job I had. And I still tell people, it was the best team of people, the best job God gave me. And through prayers, we can always find the God's answer, but we learn to live and we live to learn. Thank God for Ramona and all her work. She's an angel from God. And this pastor used to say, death is transformation from a life to a better life, the life we are looking for. And love you, Ramona, always. God bless you.
I just want to give one more opportunity for anyone that wants to come up and share, and we'll go on to the next part of our service.
I just wanted to follow in the footsteps of my daughter, who's just so sweet and cute, like coming up here. And Vera was actually almost born on Grandma's Mona's birthday. She was born on January 14th at 8:20 p.m. So she, you know, just barely missed it. And we were all kind of like hoping that she would make it. But yeah, Vera is a little sassy little girl, just like Grandma. So I think they both got kind of the same Capricorn personalities. But yeah, I drove down 16 hours to get here, and every Christmas I would drive down just to see Grandma Mona, and you know, see the whole family too. But it was really important to me to see Grandma Mona every year. And I always knew that if I missed one year, like I wouldn't see her again the next year. And I couldn't see her this year because of coronavirus. And so I just had a feeling. So I'm gonna really miss coming down here, you know, every year for Christmas. And but I think, you know, Grandma Mona appreciated it and showed me a lot about what it meant to be like a young mother, a young working mother, and just was always like supportive of me and my family. So.
I just want to say that from me, my family, my brothers, my sisters, my cousins, my Aunt Mona was in a whole totally. She was just the most specialist person that you could ever have on your side. She was always so loving. She would like to hear a good joke. Her laughter just filled you, just made you happy. I'm gonna miss her, and I know that every one of us, my mother, my aunts, we're all gonna miss her, because when she came into a house, she filled that house with her love. You never felt unloved, you always felt love. For me, she is somebody that I will never, ever, ever lose in my heart. She will always be with me. Thanks.
Thank all those who came up to share their fond memories of Ramona. And as we reflect upon her life, there's a lot of neat things that we can gather from the life of Ramona that we can use in our own lives as individuals, you know, and how her life was reflect the personality and the character that she had carried out everything that we see today. Yes, in a time of death, it's a time for us to remember the light, but also it's a time for us as a people to reflect and to look upon God, to know that God is always mindful of us in every situation that we are in our lives, that God is faithful to see us through, even in our difficult times and our time of hardship, and even in the storms of life, that God will hold our right hand, saying unto us that he will help us. It's a time for us to look to God for comfort. Time for us to look to him to bring strength in these times that we are going through today. Because he says in his word that blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. And we are comforted knowing that God is with us even during this time. In the word of the psalmist, in Psalm 116 verse 15, it says, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saint. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saint. When we think about the word precious, the meaning of the word precious, it says it simply means something is expensive, rare, and costly. Something that is expensive, rare, and costly. And when we think about Ramona, Ramona was rare. She was a rare person in the sense that her character that many of us are able to witness today, it shows forth what God was doing in her life. You know, she was costly. You know, it's costly for us to let her go, but yet we know that she's in good hands today. She's in the hands of God. She's there rejoicing with her maker. And that means, it does not mean something is love or adore. The word precious does not mean that something that is love or adore. The word means the things is questioned isn't something to be unsure or doubtful about or taken lightly, which is precisely what the psalmist is saying. God doesn't take the death of his saint so lightly. The Lord that we serve does not take the death of his saint so lightly. God values his saints, and their death is a costly thing in his sight. Which is why in the case of this particular psalm, God preserved the life of his saint. The death of any of God's people is not something that he takes lightly. When we think about God, he does not take lightly the death of anyone that loves him and has a relationship with him. In God's sight, the death of a 92-year-old, you know, elderly, it's just as costly as the death of a 20-year-old, you know, a young adult. Human beings sometimes thinks that death of a 20-year-old somehow is more costly because, you know, they're growing up in life. They're coming up in life. And so their whole life, they had their whole life before them, but now they have passed on from this life. And so us as human, we look at that as, you know, well, you know, that's a costly death. But yet in reality, when we look at God, God sees everything, you know, all of us as the same. See, God doesn't seem to think so. God takes all death seriously. He takes death so seriously that he sent his only son, Christ Jesus, to die on the cross and to defeat death. For us as believers, our confident expectation is that God will save us from all death. Because of the atoning blood of Christ Jesus, our Lord, we are God's saints, and all his saints, you know, will once again walk before the Lord in the land of the living. Folks, that is where our aim is at. Our confidence and our aim is in that one day we will spend eternity with God in heaven. And that is where Ramona is at today. She's there in the presence of God, rejoicing with her maker. She has a new body, for Paul says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 that he has created for us a new body, a glorified body that is not made by human hands, but is made by God himself. And that's the new body that Ramona has today in the presence of God, rejoicing with her maker. This happens when we believe and accept the Lord Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Our hope is in the resurrection, like that of Lazarus. Jesus may not save us from dying, but he will most certainly save us from staying dead, right? He might not save us from dying, but yet he will save us to eternity when we give our life to him, when we accept him as our Lord and Savior, and he will raise us up again. Remember, Paul says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13, that we should not mourn like people with no hope, but we have a hope, and that hope is in Christ Jesus. For Jesus is the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in him, though he dies, he will live again, as John mentioned in John chapter 11, verse 25. See, we no longer fear death because death has been and is been and being defeated. As Paul reminds us in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 54 and 50 to 57, where he says, so when this corruptible has put on incorruption, when this corruptible body put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. See, we no longer fear death because we will be saved from death. We will be saved because glorious is the Lord and righteous. Our God is merciful, as mentioned in Psalm 116, verse 5. Let us, just kind of ponder and look at Paul's statement there in Philippians chapter 1, verse 21, where he says, to live is Christ and to die is gain. As believers, our lives are to bring glory to God. And Paul had the assurance that even in his suffering, he has accomplished that goal. And that is to bring glory to God. Yet when we read in the second part of this verse, to live is Christ and to die is gain. In the second part of this verse, Paul knew that his death would bring glory to God as well. And not only that, but his faith would also come to completion and he will live with the Savior, his Savior, Christ Jesus, forever. That means to die is the gain. See, for us to die, if we gain eternity. And that's where Ramona is at today. She died from this life. Remember, she lived her life for Christ. She gave everything that she had so that she can bring glory to God. But in her death, she brought glory to God because now she is in the presence of her Lord and her Savior, Christ Jesus, this day. See, Paul longed for that day when death will bring him face to face with Jesus. As he says, for I am hard pressed between the two, having a desire to depart and be with Christ, which is far better. That is what Paul was saying there in his passage of scripture, that he was hard pressed. It was hard for him to choose between the two. If he was going to stay here on earth and to live his life to bring honor to God or to be with the Lord. And Paul is saying here, having a desire to depart and be with Christ, which is far better. Folks, yes, we wanted Ramona to stay, a little bit longer with us here on earth, right? But see, Ramona was ready to go home and be with the Lord. It was hard for her to say, you know what? I want to stay here. I want to just continue to love my family, love my grandkids, love my great-grandkids or great-great-grandkids. I love to be around my kids. And I love to be around my friends. And I love to just hang out with my friends and do line dancing, right? But then in her mind, in her heart, she's saying, well, I would rather see Christ Jesus, my Lord, face to face. I would rather be there in the presence of God, dancing in the presence of my Lord and my Savior today. And that's where she's at, folks. Families and friends, Ramona today is dancing in that street of gold. See, as believers, death brings us to the reality we will pass on from this life. That one day we are appointed to pass on from this life. But the question is, where are you going to end up at? Where are you going to spend eternity? Folks, eternity, we see that there's heaven and there's hell. Where are you going to spend eternity when you pass on from this life? And how do you secure your eternity in heaven? It's by giving your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, by accepting him as your Lord and your Savior, by serving him, by loving him, and having a relationship with him. You see, that's what Ramona had that. She loved the Lord. She served God. She was faithfully attending church, you know, and she loved God with all of her heart. Like Pastor Kevin said, on that third row, right there in the center of the church there at Calvary Chapel South Bay, she would raise her hand, worshiping her God, you know, living her life to bring honor to God and to bring glory to God. And the decision that we need to make today, it affects our eternity. It just doesn't affect you and I today right here. But how are we going to live our life after this life? Because we are appointed one day that we are going to pass on from this life. Folks, Jesus said there in John chapter 14, verse 1 to 3, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go and prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also." What a great promise, what a great encouragement for us today. The encouragement for us today is that don't let your heart be troubled. Don't be dismayed. Do not be distressed or be depressed because we don't see Ramona here any longer. But let us be encouraged to know that Jesus Christ has gone to prepare a place for us. And he gives us a promise to say to us that I will come again. And that is the hope that we have in Christ Jesus. That one day he will return so that you and I might be with him there in glory. Where Ramona is at today. She is there in the presence of her Maker, rejoicing with God, seeing the Lord Jesus face to face. And that is where our heart's desire should be. That our heart's desire should be there, you know, with God. One day we will see him face to face. With that we shall walk on a street of gold. And that there's no more tears, there's no more crying. You know, we don't have to weep anymore, but we can rejoice all the time. And that's why it's important, folks, that we secure our security in Christ Jesus. Be encouraged today, folks. Be encouraged that Christ Jesus has gone to prepare a place and he's going to come again so that you and I can be with him in glory. Folks, believe in Christ Jesus as Lord and Savior of our lives. Place your hope in him, for he will return as he promised, because he desires that you and I will be there in heaven, a place where Ramona is at today. And it starts with us, you and I, securing our eternity in heaven by accepting Christ Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Be encouraged to know that he's mindful of you, that no matter how difficult the race that we are in today, that he's always faithful to walk us through every single hard step of the way. Every single step that we take, that he will walk alongside us. It says in Isaiah 41 verse 13, that fear not, for I will hold your right hand, saying unto you, I will help you. No matter how difficult the road that we travel, no matter how many times we fall on our face and get back up, he will always remind us, fear not, I will hold your right hand, saying unto you, I will help. God is always there to help us, even when we shed tears, even when we cry, even when we, you know, when we miss the presence of Ramona in our lives. He's always mindful to hold our right hand, saying unto us, I'm right here with you. He will spare us. He will wipe away our tears, and he will give us the strength to endure through our difficult times. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for your word this morning that brings comfort to our hearts. And Lord, we ask, Father, that you will be with us this morning, that you continue to comfort our hearts, even throughout these times that we go through, the difficult times in our lives. And maybe some of us that are here this morning have never given our life to Christ. And maybe you're saying, I want to be where that in that place today where Ramona is at. I want to be there in heaven with her, rejoicing with her, dancing before the Lord. You know, maybe that is you this morning. If your eyes are closed and your head's bowed, If that is you, would you just simply just raise your hand just so that I might pray for you? Just raise your hand real quick, put it up, and just put it right back down that I might pray for you, if that's you. And maybe you didn't raise your hand, and maybe your heart is just, God is just speaking to your heart. Just go ahead and repeat this simple prayer after me. Dear Jesus, I confess that I am a sinner falling short of your glory. And I ask that you come into my heart and be the Lord and the Savior of my life. I ask that you will take over my life today, write my name in the book of life, and give me a new start. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, if you pray that prayer with me this morning, just tell somebody that you did pray that prayer, and then you have allowed Christ Jesus to be the Lord of your life, so that you one day can spend eternity where Ramona is at today. At this time, we have a video presentation of the life of Ramona Hurtado.
Thank you. imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I do is forever, forever worship you.
She was such a country music fan, I would have played some George Strait for her today, but well, what a privilege. Hey, can we do something? Can we all stand? We're going to sing a song together that I think every one of us knows. We're going to sing about Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost. Oh, I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Now listen to this. Oh, my chains are gone. I've been set free.
My God, my Savior has ransomed me, and like a flood, God's mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me, and like a flood, His mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace, unending love, amazing grace.
And Heavenly Father, thank you for that amazing grace that we've got to experience today. Lord, even with masks on and even distanced and even still kind of reeling from 2020 and all that's happened in our lives, Lord, you are still on the throne, as Pastor Tavai said. You still care about us. You still love us, Lord. Jesus, you're still coming back one day. None of your promises have changed for us, Lord. We can depend on you. And so we pray now, Lord, for peace over the family, just for the memories to be sweeter and sweeter and sweeter every day, that the grandchildren and the granddaughters would want to grow up and be just like her. And so, Father, if there's a way to do it, would you just give our regards to her up there? We pray, Lord, for peace and strength and your love and grace to continue in our lives, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
And this concludes our service here today. And just want to thank you for your attendance to our service this morning. To say see you later to Ramona. And just know that you are very appreciated today by the family. The family just let me know that there will be no gathering. Families and friends following this event due to COVID restriction. So with that, this brings our service to a close. I'd like to turn it over to the young ladies here.